I'm really looking forward to it this year. I've had a little bit more time to relax and sink into it. It's been a busy day, as always. The awards is all about celebrating innovation within the aesthetic industry and clinical excellence amongst practices within the aesthetic sector. So we've got, we must have had about 2,500 industry people involved this year and about 25,000 consumers voting for their favourite product. So it's going to be an exciting night. Yeah, there's a number of brands that have been around for a while, but there's a lot of new companies bringing out new innovations, which is great to see them just on the shortlist, because being on a shortlist finalist list is just, it's big enough just to be here tonight. But there are some exciting things coming out. I can't tell you too much, but our big, most prestigious award category is the most innovative product, and you're going to see some really interesting products. But I think, you know, the industry is changing at such a rapid pace, and there's some great things you're going to see tonight. I still think the biggest trends of today and for the next couple of years is all around body reshaping. Is all these new devices coming out. Although the plastic surgeons always reveal that liposuction procedures are going down, it's because of the boom of the non-surgical, semi-invasive types of treatments. Things like radio frequency, ultrasound, the technology is so good, but people can come in their lunch breaks, have a treatment to help reduce the waistline and then go back to work. And no one's really known that they've been at the clinic. So I think minimum downtime treatments and just with advanced technology and better results, I think is where it's all going. Yeah, the Dr. Fab series is on all the local channels, on Freeview Channel 8, and also on some of the national Sky channels. Pretty exciting. It's a lifestyle show. It covers everything from diet, lifestyle, aesthetics. We've got some great celebrity interviews. So that will be running for the next sort of 3 months on those channels. But I'm busy. We've got the Australasian Awards in 2 weeks' time, so I'm flying over to Sydney, and then we've got Los Angeles that we're about to kick off in Beverly Hills next year. So it's all about preparation at the moment. I think the rewards I get from being involved with on television is really sort of being able to be at the forefront and sort of help consumers simplify their beauty choices. Sometimes, you know, it can be a little bit technical what some of the doctors and plastic surgeons tell consumers, but I'm sort of the in-between, I suppose, the translator. But it's all about simplifying consumers' beauty choices, because they're so complicated today, and we really just want to get the message out there and make aesthetic beauty more accessible to everyone. I think cosmetic treatments in general, it's more around the non-surgical treatments today. Surgical is still important for some particular patients, but consumers really want something that has minimum downtime, doesn't hurt, no one wants anything to hurt, and the results are good. So I think you'll see a big change, especially in America. It's like something that people go to the supermarket, they're going to go to their cosmetic clinics. It's happening in America, and it's going to be coming to the UK, where everyone is going to be having these treatments just because it's non-invasive. So, yeah.